Story.
You ready?
Yeah.
Once upon a time, there was a frog, a log, a cricket, a dog, and they all went for a walk in the ocean. The frog, the log, the cricket, the dog. The dog said, "Hey, log, how did you get to the ocean? You're just a piece of wood. Shouldn't things like you just float away?" And the log said to the dog, "Hey, don't worry about me. I've been living in oceans forever. I know where I'm going." So the dog and the log jumped into the ocean. The waves were big. They were splashing hard. It was a fun day to play. The sun was out. It was shining. It was warm. They could feel the heat of the sun. The cricket and the frog said, "Whoa, that's a little bit too much for us. We should probably stay out of the ocean. We might get washed away." Well, they said, "All we gotta do is hop on the dog and hop on the log. And we'll ride them in the ocean. We'll hold on for dear life if a wave tries to wash us away." So they got near the edge of the ocean where the dog and the log were playing. The cricket looked at the frog and said, "Now's our time. Let's go." And they hopped out to the dog and out to the log. The cricket jumped on the log, the frog on the dog. And they held on while they played. Out in the distance of the ocean, there was a giant wave coming in. And they saw it. They said, "Hey guys, look, the biggest wave you've ever seen. It's coming. Who wants to ride it?" They all said, we do, let's go, let's go." So the frog on the dog and the cricket on the log walked out further into the ocean. The giant wave came closer and closer. Their eyeballs grew bigger and bigger. Of course, the log didn't have eyeballs, did it? It's just a piece of wood. But it could feel what was happening. It could feel the waves coming. They said, "Boys, this is going to be a big one." And the dog barked and said, "Yep, I can't wait." And the frog just gulped. And the cricket just cricketed. And they went out toward the wave. And in it came. It rolled like thunder. It rolled like a giant barrel, smashing and banging everything it saw. And it came closer and closer. And they looked up. It was way above their head. Over their heads. It smashed them. They got all curled around. It tossed them. It turned them underneath the water. They couldn't get up. The dog said to the frog, "Hold on, I'll try and make it through." The cricket barely was able to hold on to the log, which was slashing and banging. And then it went black. The wave put them to sleep. And now they were floating. The sand began to open up, swirling around and around and around, and it sucked them around in circles, faster and faster, and then it sucked them into the sand underneath the ocean floor, and they fell all the way down this tunnel. There was no water anymore. It was just the dog, the frog, the log, and the cricket. And they rolled down the hill. They bumped into a tree. And off into a castle. Underneath the ocean. The castle door opened up. And out came two giant ants. The ants were dressed like knights. They had swords and armor on, metal helmets. And they approached the dog, the frog, the cricket, and the log. And they said, "Hey, you there, how did you get here?" They said, "We don't know. We were playing in the ocean, and a giant wave came, the biggest wave we've ever seen, and it smashed us and smoked us, and it spun us around, and it sucked us down into the sand and put us asleep. And then it dropped us down this tunnel, down this hill, and we crashed against a tree and landed at your castle. And they picked them up, the ants. They put them in handcuffs. Oh boy, the dog and the frog and the log and the cricket were very scared now. What has happened to us? Where are we? They said, quiet, walk straight forward. So they walked straight forward through the castle, down into a dark tunnel, into a dungeon. They opened a creaky old, smelly, wet door. Then threw the dog, the frog, the log, and the cricket inside. And he said, there you'll stay. Forever. Oh, no. And they began to cry. I don't want to stay here forever. I don't know where we are or what's happening. The cricket said, guys, that's enough. Everybody, let's find a way out. This must be a dream. This must be a trap. This must be something that we can escape, because it doesn't make any sense. And the dog just laid there. He was very sad. And the log fell over beside him and he said, hey, dog, it's okay. Frog's gonna get us out of here. And the cricket just cricketed. Didn't have much to say, really. So the log said to the frog, hey, frog, how are you gonna get us out of here? Do you have a plan? And the frog said, just let me think. He looked around. There was no windows. There was no cracks. There was nothing to escape from. It was totally dark. It smelled wet. It was cold. It was made of stone. And there appeared to be no way to escape. The frog said, I'm thinking, but I can't. There's just nothing around here to slip through to get outside. What if when the guards come back, we somehow run out underneath their legs? So they said, hey, maybe that's a good plan. We'll do that. Sure enough, about 2 hours later, they could hear the ants' footsteps. You could hear the chains. The key, they put it in the lock and opened the door. And at that very moment, the frog said, rabbit run! And they all ran toward the ants. And they bowled the ants over, got past them. The dog had the log in his mouth. The cricket was still on the log, and the frog jumped on the dog. So the dog was carrying all of them, and he ran as fast as he could. And the ants could not keep up with him. But you know what they had? They had an whole army. So they called their friends. The dog, the frog, the log, and the cricket. They're escaping. Quickly, stop them. And all the ants came down from everywhere. Every step, every hallway, every ladder, every window they came out of. And they rushed toward the dog. But the dog was so fast. He ran upstairs, downstairs, instairs, outstairs, through hallways, through bedrooms. He didn't know where he was going, but he was trying to get out. There was no windows in this castle. He knew nowhere to go. He just ran around in circles and circles. And finally, they got trapped again. The ants circled around them. There was nowhere to run. What were they going to do? How would they escape this with all the ants around them?
Open the door and run.
Open the door and run? Well, let's find out what happened. All the ants made a perfect circle around them. The dog was carrying the log in his mouth and the frog on his back and the cricket on the log. And they didn't see any holes in the legs they could run through. There were so many ants, hundreds of them, all with armors and swords pointing at them. They were afraid that if they ran right at them, that would be the end of them. So the frog hopped off the dog and he said, I got a plan. And just then, a rumble could be be heard in the distance. The castle began to shake. Oh, the ants, you could tell they didn't know what was going on because they began to look around like, what's happening? The frog said, guys, I think this is our chance. There's a door over there. Let's run towards it. The castle began to really shake. Dust was falling. Bricks began to fall. Stones crashing down. And then the wall blew out. Water poured in. And it threw everybody together. It was a big mess of ants and dogs and frogs and logs and crickets everywhere. They rumbled around and rolled around each other, the water crashing through them. It filled up the castle. They all rose to the top and the roof blew off from the force of the water. There was so much water inside. And the water threw them all outside. They were back in the ocean again. They all came up to the top. The dog took the frog and the log and the cricket, and he began to dog paddle as fast as he could away from the ants. The ants, they couldn't swim. They didn't know what to do. So that they were getting away finally. And they dog paddled and dog paddled and dog paddled. And they could see the shore. And they said, we're going to get to the shore. We're going to get out of here. And then they looked behind them. Oh no, another giant wave. We don't want this to happen again. Another giant wave comes over top of them and slams them. And they got separated. Blew apart. Oh no, the dog lost the frog and the log out of his mouth, and the cricket was gone, and they were all just washed away. The waters grew calm, and you couldn't see anything, just water everywhere you looked. And then the dog's head bobbed up. He was still dog paddling, but he was alone. The frog was gone, the log was gone, and the cricket was gone. The dog was alone. He looked around for his friends. He couldn't see them anywhere. He was scared. He began to paddle as fast as he could, but he didn't know where the shore was. He couldn't see it anymore. It was all just water, giant water. And then he looked back. Oh no, here comes another wave. It picked him up and threw him across the ocean, and he landed on an island. He was exhausted. He was scared. He looked around. In the distance, he thought he could see some people. So he began to run toward those people. And he ran closer and closer, and then he stopped in his tracks. It was the ants. The ants were on this island. They also had been washed up. There must have been 20 of them. Oh God, what do I do? They noticed him, and he started to run the other way. And they said, stop, 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 stop. We want to help. We're scared too. So he stopped. He turned around. He tried to think, could I trust them? Are they being truthful? Are they trying to trap me? They said, stop. We don't want to hurt you. We're sorry for what happened. And the dog said, I've lost my friends, the log, the frog, and the cricket. They said, we know we've lost a lot of our friends too. But we know the way out. But we've got to work together. And the dog said, okay, let's do it. So the ants began to do what ants do. They work very well as teams. Then they began to dig into the sand. Underneath the sand, they worked one by one by one by one, constantly over and over digging. One would dig, he would move out, the next one would come in and she would dig, and then he would dig and she would dig, and they would all dig constantly until they made a tunnel underneath the sand, underneath the ocean, deep enough to go back to where the castle once stood. The dog followed them down the tunnel. They went through the water, through the sand, and they found pieces of their tunnels, just rocks now. It was broken. And the ant said, oh, our home is gone. What do we do now? So they said we gotta go back into the water. We gotta hope a wave comes and carries us to the shore. So the ants dug up to the water. The dog went with them. And sure enough, they got to the ocean. And a giant wave was coming again. What was as loud as thunder? And it slammed into them. Carried them, picked them up. And threw them all for miles. And they all landed back on the beach where the frog, the dog, the log, and the cricket once began. And the dog said, I'm back. I'm back home. But he was without his friends. He felt sad and scared. And he waited there for days for his friends to come home, and they never came. So finally, after 3 weeks, he left. And he knew he would never see the log, the frog, or the cricket again. So he walked back to his home, down the street, through the alleyway, onto the porch, and he scratched on the door. The door opened, and there was Myla. You're home! Oh, I missed you. I thought you were gone forever. The girl bent down and hugged the dog and gave him a big kiss. He came in. She said, oh, you look so wet and tired. What has happened to you? She just hugged him, and they laid on the couch, and she fed him and gave him water. And that's where the story ended. Sometimes in life, you don't get back what you want. And that dog had to learn to live and be happy again, without frog, without log, without cricket. And time went on, and as he learned to play again and live life, he eventually found new things to play with, new friends, a new log, a new frog, and a new cricket. And he became happy again, although he missed old frog, old log, and old cricket. And that's just how it goes. The end.